art is the cuddly add-on thing that you add on that makes people feel good. Of course, there's catharsis in art, but art is actually a site of inquiry, and it's a muscle and a discipline.
And by taking the lead from the press communities, and then using the resources that they have to make those things happen, and trusting that the outcome will be climate connected.
Art is essential to learning, to play, to communicating, and there's real love there, isn't there?
And every time I felt like I can't do this anymore, I would go and look at their photos, and it would inspire me, like in a way that kind of reading about this stuff or reading about the news overwhelms you, and sometimes you don't want to talk about it with people.
Stories are really good ways of talking about stuff, because then, like, when we have a story as opposed to a concept, because, like, concepts are helpful, but then most people are just like, what the f*** does that mean? But then if someone gave me a story to illustrate the concept and then told me the concept, rather than people assuming that concepts are known. And I find that when I work with, like, young people, it's so much easier, like, the ways that young people then tell you what you've said to them is such a useful tool for really understanding.
Built on the legacy of resistance.
That space, it's inviting the express, like the artistic expression in you, whatever the shape that is. And hopefully that space will be able to appreciate it. Some people might like to sing, some people might like to paint.
You know, within activism type work or even campaigning, to like feel like you've achieved something, because the problems are so big, people have expressed themselves and they've shared their understanding of what it means to them.
What you do, you know, they were survival strategies, but also like creating some resilience tools too.
It's definitely a hierarchy in the arts as well as the practitioners who will command a fee for their expertise and everything. And that really does. I think there's so much that will be missed if we don't also value the arts of everybody.
Hopefully not regarding art as like an externality, like something that is extra to this new culture, something that is integral and needs to happen at some point.
One of the key things has been using art through loads of different mediums to connect on like a personal level.
We would do singing, we do dancing, we do, you know, do body work, do yoga, lots of different things, because, you know, it's there's a whole shift when you can inhabit your body with other human beings. That's trust, and that's allowing yourself to be seen.
Art is a really useful tool to engage people in any issue, really, but particularly big issues which are hard to get a hold on, hard to grasp, and quite scary, because it's a way of getting through filters.
What is the arts? What is the arts to people who've grown up in the Niger Delta forever and who haven't had the benefit, in inverted commas, of Renaissance and Enlightenment thinking to recognise that the arts are this particular set of things? It's a whole lot of absolute. What do you mean? Yeah? We live art all the time. We are art.
What kind of binds that together is the understanding of this need to create new practice. And wherever there is a gap, because of this lack of connection that we have with the land, art can be a place where we can join it back.
And also that creativity, as John Lawrence Rose talks about, is like, is also like community work. It's like, this is your reconfiguring your reality. Like, that is creative practice. It's visioning.
How we work with communities, very much meeting them where they are at, working in a very collaborative and a co-produced way to enable people to have conversations about whatever they need to have conversations about, and very much using arts and creativity to be able to provide the space and the trust and have all the sort of ingredients that you need to have some of these conversations.
Recognising different forms of art as like a meaningful action. Even if the only thing that those art forms are doing is communicating, like that's making more people suddenly like resonate with it, or like learn something, or feel like it's relevant to them, or just inspire them to do something themselves, then obviously that's like super, you know, great outcome.
I think where you do this sort of like awakening the creative, there's a vulnerability that comes with that. You can create like equitable spaces where you are forced into doing something that you're like either not good at or that reveals a part of you. And somatic work is like as well, when you don't necessarily have to get people to confess that everything that's on their heart, but just by being honest in their bodies, they can still feel that sense of connection with other people.
We want to be intergenerational, we want to remain teachable.
Keeping it local and relevant to people.
The potential of looking at what an alternative world can look like and dreaming that. And if you can dream that, then maybe you can work towards it with other people.
And then also about the role of arts in movement building. Like, you know, movements are in chanting, movements are in song. The ways that we relate with one another is very experiential. Processes are so important.
Art could be in anything. Like, literally, it could be anything. Mm-hmm. It's like engaging in ideas in an artistic and like fun way. Engaging in whatever conversation you're trying to have in a creative way. And kind of avoid making those conversations an intellectual debate, because that's what happens. Just like art is a really personal way of engaging with really complex ideas.
You know, it can be get a bit kind of academic and complex when you're trying to understand like climate crisis and like really structural like inequality issues. So if they can be communicated through art.
Understanding the value of what art is in decolonizing knowledge sets of power and knowledge, and also the hierarchy of knowledge.
Another reason why we used art in refugee youth as a tool for dialogue, because it's a tool that we can all speak without needing a dictionary to translate.
You can do a collaboration with partners from Global South to do art with you. You kind of come in communion with them, and or like use it for unlearning purposes and recharging purposes. Like, it's such a source of joy.
But actually to like allow whatever your art forms are to grow and to work you and to be in relationship with you is so incredible. And it does the most anti-capitalist thing, because here you have this thing within you that nobody else is responsible for, that's within you, and you have to take responsibility for nurturing, to grow it. And it supports your sense of self, and it resources you, and it helps you understand how powerful and worthy you are and unique.